Back to the second chapter, amen. And thanks to God, let's make sure that we, amen, work with our children, amen, so that there's expressions to the Spirit of God, amen. And I just thank God for His presence this morning, amen. If you couldn't feel His presence, you might be kind of dead spiritually, amen. And I know God's presence was on my wife so strong because the woman broke my hand, amen, squeezing my hand. Oh, I told Deacon Turner, come get your door. Amen. This is a turn to she-woman. I ain't never felt that scream come from her before. That's why you heard me tell him, Deacon, come get your door. Because she was squeezing my hand so tight. Amen. It felt like my hand was about to break. Amen. So I know it was the power of God. Amen. Back to the second chapter. Verses 1 through 3 is the verses we would deal with. Back in the second chapter, verse 1 through 3, and I'll be out your way. It is 12:35. Amen. We believe God will be out here before 1 something. Amen. Amen. But we want to let God have His way.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Me and Deacon Turner had a wonderful time in prayer here yesterday. Amen. We really prayed and prayed and prayed. And I'm telling you, God's presence filled this place. Amen. And when we left out, amen, we were jumping and leaping and amen. I believe you would have put 10 men out there. We would have whooped all 10 of them. Amen. Back on the second chapter. Amen. Verses 1 through 3. That's the praying deacon. That's what I call him. The praying deacon. When I got over here, that's what he was doing, praying. Look at Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 1 through 3. I might get one to one wife and help her. Amen. I will stand up on my watch and set me up on the tower. I will watch to see what he will say unto me and what I shall answer when I am corrected. Yeah. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision and make it plain upon tables that he may run and read it. For the vision is yet for a appointed time.
Yeah.
But at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it.
Yeah.
Somebody say, wait for it.
Wait for it.
Because it shall surely come to pass.
Yeah.
It will not tarry. Look at your neighbor,
neighbor.
Whatever God has promised you,
wait for it.
It will surely
come to pass.
Come on, say, neighbor.
Whatever
God has promised you,
wait for it.
It will surely come to pass. One more time, say,
neighbor,
whatever
God
has promised you,
wait for it.
It will surely
come to pass.
Genesis, the 8th chapter, verse 22, he said, as long as the earth remains, seed time and harvest will not cease. Now, saints of God, we really don't have a problem with the sowing, but what we have a problem with is waiting for the harvest to come in. See, we don't have no problem when God give us a promise. We have a problem waiting on God until the promise manifests itself.
Yes.
We are a fast-paced generation. We are a microwave generation. That everything is at the tip of our fingers. Do you hear me, saints of God? If we want to know something, we just go to Google, we link it up, and it's over with. But saints of God, we have gotten to the place where we do not want to wait on God. You can go to any church around America, and if the worship is too long, you start losing people. People start getting up walking out. You know why? Because people don't want to wait up on God. But saints of God, if God has given you a promise, you got to learn how to wait on God. If God has spoken something to you in your life, guess what? You got to learn how to wait on God. Now, saints of God, before we go on, I want to tell you that you need to make sure that the thing that you're waiting on God for came from God. You need to make sure that the vision that you're waiting on God to bring to pass, that it came from God. You need to make sure that the thing that you're saying God is going to bring to you, you need to make sure that God told you that's what he wants you to have. Now, since God, sometimes we can be waiting on stuff that God don't want us to have. We got to get into God's word because some stuff we asking God for, and God said, that's not according to my word, and God said, I can't give you that. Now, if you're praying to God for somebody else's husband or somebody else's wife, They say, God gonna give me that man and God gonna give me that woman. Guess what? You're gonna be waiting on that for a long time because that's against God's word. Anything that we ask God, it has to line up with his word. We have to be able to look into the word of God and say, God, is this in your word? And if this is in your word, then I know, God, that it's mine. But sometimes we got some saints, we got some people waiting on stuff that God don't even want them to have. You have to be able to go before God and say, God, is this your purpose for my life? Is this your will for my life? Sometimes we wait on stuff and God said, I don't want you to have it. You've been waiting so long, but God said, I don't want you to have it. You said, God, how come it came? Because God said, I don't want you to have it. You asking God for $1 million, and God said, I don't want you to have it. God said, you can't even deal with $10,000. What am I going to give you $1 million for? God said, if I gave you $1 million, God said, you're going to leave and get outside my presence. Some things we asking God for, sometimes it's not the time, and sometimes God is saying, I don't want you to have it. Just because you see somebody else have it, don't mean that God wants you to have it. God wants you to be able to deal with the blessing that he brings in your life. But sometimes we have a lot of saints making a lot of declarations, and God don't even want them to have it. You saying stuff that God don't even want you to have. You got to get into the word of God. And if God's word don't say it, guess what? It's not God's will. You said, what is the will of God? Get into the word and you'll see the will of God. But God also have a personal will for you. Personally tailor-made for you.
Yes.
God have a personal will tailor-made for past feelings. In certain places I can go, and in certain places I can't go.
Yes.
In certain people I can be around, and in certain people I can't be around. Do you hear me, says God? Because it will hinder what God is doing.
Yes.
But saints of God, you say God gave me a promise. You said God told me that this thing was going to come to pass, and I haven't seen it yet. My word to you is, wait on God. God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. If God has spoken, guess what? God is going to make it good. God said, my word will not return to me void, but going to do what I sent it out to do.
Yes.
The Bible declared that God's word is forever settled in heaven. Come on, saints of God. The Bible said God watch over his word to perform it. You ain't watching over God's word to perform his word. God said, I'm watching over my word to perform it.
Yes.
And God said, if I have spoken it, God said, I'm going to make it good. God said, if I told you I'm going to save your children, God said, I'm going to save your children. God said, if I told you I'm going to deliver your mind, God said, I'm going to deliver your mind. God said, if I told you I'm going to heal your body, God said, I'm going to heal your body. God said, if I told you I'm going to restore you, God said, I'm going to restore you. God said, if I told you I'm going to lift the burden, God said, I'm going to lift the burden. God said, I'm not a man that I should lie, nor the son of man that I should repent. God said, if I have spoken it, I'm going to make it good.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
So whatever God has told you, you need to understand that God is going to bring that thing to pass. But we have a little problem. And the little problem is waiting. Because this generation don't want to wait on God. We get in a rush in traffic because don't nobody want to wait. They'll swerve around you and almost run you off the road just to get to the stoplight at the same time as you.
Yeah.
You hear me, says God, you ain't even going nowhere and you driving that fast.
Yes.
Because we have an impatient spirit that's in the land and an impatient spirit that's in the house of God. But saints of God, you got to learn how to wait.
Yes.
Learn how to wait when you're in worship. Learn how to wait when you're in prayer. Learn how to wait when you are praising and magnifying God.
Yes.
Saints of God, you got to learn how to wait.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
We can't hurry, God. But we got to learn how to wait. And Habakkuk, the same book that my wife came from this morning, in the second chapter, the prophet was told a vision, but the prophet was told it's going to come, but you got to wait. I want to tell you what to do, saints of God, while you're waiting. Cut there on a little bit. I want to tell you what to do while you're waiting.
Yes.
Look at verse 1. The first thing he said, what did he say in chapter 1? He said, I will stand upon my watch.
Uh-huh.
You got to make this thing personal, saints of God. He said, I'm going to stand upon my watch. Which means you got to make this thing personal that you're going to stand. When you wait on God for something, you got to make the conscious decision that I'm going to stand. He said, I will stand upon my watch. He said, I'm not going to be moved. He said, I'm not going to be shaken. He said, I'm still going to embrace God. He said, I'm not going to let God go. He said, I will stand upon my watch. You have to make it personal. You can't be concerned about who's around you and what they're doing in the streets and what your family members are doing and what your brother and sister in Christ is doing in the house of God. Say to God, you got to make it personal, just like Habakkuk. He said, I don't understand. He said, I'm waiting on God. And he said, I will. Bless the Lord at all times. He said, and his praise shall continue to be in my mouth. Saints of God, you got to make the decision that I will.
I will.
You got to make it a personal thing.
Yes.
He said, I will stand upon my watch. Stand means to position yourself.
Yes.
Because saints of God, while you wait on the vision of God and the promise of God and the plans of God and the purpose of God for your life, you got to position yourself. You got to learn, saints of God, how to position yourself. Some of us are waiting on a promise from God, but we have not positioned ourselves. But the prophet said, before God speak, I'm going to position myself. He said, before God speak, he said, I'm going to position myself.
Yes.
He said, I will stand.
I will stand.
Having done all to stand, stand therefore.
Uh-huh.
You say, what do I do when I'm getting weary and I don't know what to do? The Bible said, having done all to do, he said, stand.
Stand.
When you don't know what to do, keep on standing.
Yes.
He said, I will stand upon my watch. Which means my guard. Saints of God, when you believe in God for something, stay on your guard. Don't let down your guard, saints of God. Your watch means your function. He said, I'm going to stand up on my function. He said, what God has called me to do, I'm going to stand up on my function. Some of us get off our function when things don't go our way. But the prophet said, I'm going to stand up on my function. He said, I'm going to stand on this office of being a prophet. He said, I'm going to stand in that holy place. He said, I'm going to stand in that secret place. He said, I'm going to stand in the presence of God. He said, I'm going to stand up on my watch. Saints of God, while you're waiting on God, and you're believing for God for the impossible, let your leader say, stand upon your watch. Don't get off your watch, but stay up on your post. Stay up on your function. What if God called you to do? If God called you to be a deacon, stand up on your watch. If God has called you to be a prophet or a prophetess, stand up on your watch. If God has called you to be a pastor or evangelist or apostle, stand up on your watch. If God has called you to be a usher or a singer, stand up on your watch. If God has called you to be an altar boy to serve in the house of God, stand up on your watch. I don't care whatever God has called you to do, saints of God, learn how to stand up on your watch. He said, I'm going to
stand.
Upon my watch. And while I'm praying, I'm going to stand. While I'm fasting, I'm going to stand.
Yes.
Even if I'm hurting, I'm going to stand. Even if they leave me, I'm going to stand.
Yes.
Even if they betray me, I'm going to stand. Even when they talk about me, I'm going to stand. He said, I'm going to stand.
Yes, Lord.
Upon my watch. He said, the post that God put me on, I'm going to stand on it. He said, I don't understand what's going on, but I'm going to stand up on the watch. When you don't understand what's going on, stand up on your watch. Come on, say, so God,
yes.
When things around you are going crazy, stand up on your watch. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Stay down in the place of prayer. Stay down in the place of consecration. Stay down in the place of His presence. Stand up on your watch.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Lord.
He said, I will stand upon my watch. I'm going to stay up on my guard. I'm not going to get off my guard. The place where God placed me, he said, I'm going to stand.
Yes,
we have a lot of people who have left their post.
Yes, Lord.
And they function.
Uh-huh.
In their office. In they whatever God placed them at, they move from it. Because I've been waiting on God for 3 years, and God ain't did it yet. And God ain't spoke to me yet. Therefore, they got off their post. Do you hear me? Say, God, don't get off your post. While you're waiting on God, a thing that God promised you, stay on your post. You better stay on your post for them children. You better not get off your post. If you get off your post, let me tell you something, get ready to come in. You better stay on your post. You better keep on crying out to God. Don't you get off your post for that marriage. You better stay on your post. Do you hear me? Say, God, if you want God to deliver, if you want God to set free, if you want God to turn it around, if you want God to strengthen it, you got to stand up on your post. Do you hear me, says God? Stand on your post for your marriage. Stand on your post for your children. Stand on your post for your ministry. You got to stand on your post. He said, I will stand upon my watch and set me upon a tower. There we go, says God. Set me needs a position. He said, I'm going to position myself on the tower because I'm waiting to see what God going to say to me. I asked God something, and God told me, and now I got to sit up on my tower. Back in this time, a tower was a high place. It was a tower that went straight up. and what a tower was, a high place. Saints of God, we got to learn how to get into a high place in the spirit while we're waiting on God. And what was a tower? A tower was something that they used to look out to observe when enemy armies was coming to the nation. You get on that tower, you can see the enemy way before he got there. And a man on a tower would turn around and call and say, there's an army coming. Why? Because he in the tower and he see the enemy before he get there. And saints of God, why are you waiting on God to bring that promise to pass? You need to set yourself on your tower. You need to get in the watchtower. You need a watchtower in your family. You need a watchtower in your marriage. You need a watchtower. You need to be able to see the enemy before he get ready to come. He said, I'm going to set up there my watchtower. Don't you get off the wall, saints of God. When you're on the wall, you're on your watchtower. All this nation need a watchtower. Because this nation don't know what's coming in. You don't allow every unclean bird to come in. You killing children and doing some everything. If God don't bring no judgment on America, he got to apologize to Sodom and Gomorrah. But if America repent, God will change his mind. But as long as God seeing a doctor in a white suit, go in the room and kill a child in the room, and we excuse it because he got on a white suit and he got some licenses to do it. But you ain't did nothing but committed murder. Because murder is something that is planned out. And you got the Almighty looking at children and he's sending a womb and they come back to God. And they show back up to God. Angels bring little babies back to God. He said, Lord, they aborted them. He said, God, they sent them back. He said, God, they want them. Don't you know that some of these children that people are burdened, they was going to be doctors. They was going to come up with a cure for certain diseases. You hear that, says God. But the enemy put it in people's heart. Kill your children. How can the children tell a nation to kill their children? You know why? Because ain't nobody on the tower. Ain't nobody on the watchtower. You live in Saint Zion. But see the enemy when he coming.
Yes, Lord.
That murderous spirit is coming for our children. You will see it in prayer. You'll see it before that devil even get there. He said, I'm going to sit up on the tower. In your household, you need a tower. So you can see the enemy before he get ready to come. You got to be in a high place in the spirit. That you can see the enemy when he's trying to attack your husband and attack your wife and attack your children. But some houses that have a watchtower, they don't have no tower. They can't see the enemy before he get ready to come. But I made my mind up. When I made my God, I'm going to sit up. Myself on my tower, and I'm gonna pray. I bind the enemy from coming into my family. We ought to hear it until the above, and I be blessed, and I'm going in, and blessed, and I come out, and the fruit of my body is blessed. Thereby, I bind you. I bind even the oppressive spirit, every stressful spirit. I loose the peace of God in my house, the joy of God in my house. I loose the love of God in my house. Come on, saints of God. You have to be able to watch and pray. You need a watch tower in your house. The Bible says, I'm gonna set me on the tower.
Oh, yes. My God. Thank you, Jesus.
It's a high place. They used a tower to look out for enemies. They had towers in the vineyards. Uh-huh. So people would look over the vineyard, make sure thieves didn't come in and steal. Uh-huh. To watch out for foxes.
Uh-huh.
They came in the vineyard. When somebody in the tower saw a fox come in the vineyard, because they would eat the grapes, they would scream out and say, hey, there were a fox. Uh-huh. Or there were some foxes in the vineyard. We heard King Solomon say, let us catch the little foxes. That destroy the vine.
Yes, Lord.
See, in your marriage, you need a watchtower so you can catch the little foxes that try to come in and try to destroy your vine of love. You hear me, saints of God? This is the reason why I come. You need a watchtower. I need a watchtower in my marriage. I need a watchtower in my ministry. That when the foxes come in, I can see them before they get there. You hear me, saints of God? You need a watchtower in your marriage. Come on, saints of God. You need a watchtower in your business. Somebody in your business might be doing something underhanded.
Yes, God.
It can be short-circuiting the blessings of God.
Yes, Lord.
And sometimes you need a watchtower.
Yes,
God, let me know what's going on in my business.
Yes.
And then somebody doing something they ain't got no business. Do you hear me, saints of God? Because we got to walk in righteousness. In this business, and God is going to get ready to bless it. Bless is the man who walks out of the counsel of the ungodly. No sin in the way of the sinner. No sin in the seat of the scornful. Do you hear me, saints of God? But his delight is in the law of the Lord. And in his law he meditates day and night. He should be like a tree that's planted by the rivers of water that brings up the fruits in this season. He's lifting our river, and whatever he do, he's going to prosper. You got to keep your watchtower, saints of God. Don't you come off your post. Don't you turn down your watchtower. You better keep your watchtower. This nation need a watchtower. Our schools need a watchtower.
Oh, yes. Oh,
You took prayer after school.
Come on.
You took Jesus after school.
Yes.
And you know how come people going to AK-47 and shooting everybody up? You know why? Because when they get to the door, there's no angel at the door.
Yes.
You didn't say stop because you didn't remove Jesus outside of the school. But I'm praying for our schools. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. We need a watchtower. God, protect our children. Cover our children. Cover them in the blood of God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
Yes.
Put your hands on them, oh God. We need a watchtower.
Yes.
I'm going to stand.
Stand
up. Yes, Lord.
My God. Thank you, Lord. Thank
you, Jesus. Watch now.
Yes.
I see death on you, Juju. I see it.
My God.
I see it. Your auntie just said it, but I saw it again.
My God.
Yes, Lord.
You need to be careful,
Jesus,
of what you're doing. Be careful on cars that you jump in and out of. Be careful what you're doing. See, we need a watchtower.
Yes,
we need to be able to see down the road before the enemy coming.
Yes,
he said, I'm going to sit upon my watch.
Yes.
I'm going to sit up on a watchtower. Oh my God. Say, God, get that watchtower back in your house. Say, now we got to see before the enemy get ready to come. We got to stay in the spirit.
Yes.
We got to stay in prayer. We got to stay in the fasting. We got to stay in the word of God. We got to be able to see when the enemy is coming. He's trying to come in and destroy our marriage and destroy our family. I need a watchtower in my home. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
Yes.
I'm coming to the house of God because it's a watchtower.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Why am I coming to the house of God? Because it's a watchtower.
Yes.
I can come into the house of God. Me and Dad was in here yesterday praying. Dad felt like a burden was pushing him down. And we ain't got to go into details, but it was spiritual warfare. And Dad came to the watchtower. And when he came to the watchtower, the man was down. But when he left out with energy in his body. He
didn't
say, God, because he came down to the watchtower. He didn't say, God, the watchtower, I'm going to sit myself upon a watchtower.
On a watchtower.
Oh, my God. And I'm going to watch to see what he gonna say to me.
Yes, Lord.
And look at verse 2. We going through this. And what it said in verse 2? Dad, read that, Dad.
And the Lord answered me.
We heard it this morning that God was answering you.
Yes.
But never ask God, what's going on?
Yes.
He said, I don't understand you. He said, what are you doing? But the Bible said, after you got through crying and complaining and screaming at God, the Bible said, God answered him. Oh, God loves you too much not to answer you.
Yes.
When you come into the house of God, God is answering you. When you hear the word of God being preached, God is answering you. When you go down in prayer, God is answering
yes.
you. When you go down in fasting, God is answering you. Why are you praising God? Why are you sending up Judah? Why are you shabaking God? Why are you down in worship? God is answering you.
Yes, yes, Lord.
Sometimes God answers you with a touch. He don't tell you exactly what you want to hear. When you come in sometime, he'll answer you with a touch.
Yes.
And you'll leave strengthened.
Yes.
And say, I shall live and not die.
Yes.
And declare the glory of God. But God answers you. He might not tell you what you want to hear, but he will answer you. You hear what says God?
Yes.
He said, I'm going to stand up on my watch.
Yes.
Until God speak to me.
Yes.
Some people don't be on their watch, and when God speak, they ain't there no more. They miss the answer. And say to God, while you're waiting on God, stand up on your watch.
Mm-hmm.
And God is going to answer you.
Yes,
and God told him, write the vision.
Write the vision.
God said, what I showed you, write it down. Write in Hebrew means to describe. Because say to God, when God gives you a vision, you need to be the first person to know how to describe the vision to yourself before you try to describe it to somebody else.
Yeah.
Says God, some of us need to get a vision for God for our life. We don't have no vision. We don't have no purpose. We don't have no direction. But says God, I encourage you. I implore you. Get into the presence of God and say, God, why did you create me? Why did you place me here?
Yes.
Tell me what I'm supposed to be doing. Give me the vision for my life.
Yes.
Give me the plans for my life. Give me the purpose for my life. Come on, says God. He said, write the vision for me. He said, you need to describe the vision to yourself so you can know what I'm getting ready to do.
Yeah.
Come on, saints of God. I can't tell nobody else to do what they like if I don't know what God is doing in my life. Come on, saints of God.
Yeah.
But God gave me a vision. God gave me a promise. God gave me a plan.
Yeah.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. His word is sure. Yes, Lord. His word is forever settled in the heaven.
Yeah.
If he has spoken it, it's going to come to pass.
It's going to come to pass. Yes, Lord.
He said, write the vision, which means describe.
Yes, right.
Then write means prescribe. You know how you go to the doctor and they prescribe you a certain medication?
Mm-hmm.
They give you a prescription because they prescribe it. Prescribe means to give something in writing or otherwise.
Yes.
It means to put forth a course of action.
Yes.
Say to God, while you're waiting on the plans of God, ask God to give you in writing or verbally what is the next course of action he got for your life. Do you hear me? Say to God, all God have already written you a prescription. Come on, say to God. The reason why come to the doctor will give you a prescription. So when you go to the doctor, you take that medicine, you come out feeling better. Do you hear me? Say to God, all God gave a prescription for you inside the vision that he got for you. Say to God, you just have to go and take the prescription.
Oh, yes.
Some stuff we went through in life, we never was went through. You know why? Because we didn't take God's vision and wrapped up in a vision, and wrapped up in his plans, and wrapped up in his purpose, is the prescription for your life.
Oh, yes.
That prescription stops you from getting sick.
Oh, yes.
Stop you from getting depressed and stressed out. Mm-hmm. And stop you from being defeated. But you gotta come to God and get the vision. You gotta come to God and get his plans for your life. Because when we deal with vision, it means a dream.
Mm-hmm.
What dream have God given you? It means a revelation. What revelation have God given you? A vision is an oracle, which means a word. What word have God given you?
Yeah.
See, you get directions right now. You get marching orders right now. I only go by the marching orders of God. For man shall I live by bread alone. But by every word that proceeded go forth out of the mouth of God. This is how I live. I live based on this word.
Yeah.
You hear me, says God. I walk based in his word. I wake up in the morning with his word. I go through the day with his word. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
Yeah.
Man shall I live by bread alone. But by every word that proceeded and go forth out of the mouth of God. I came into the house of God to get me a word. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. I came into the house of God to get me a ram of word. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. God sent forth your word. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. If you send forth your word, God, I can stand. If you send forth your word, God, I can make it. If you send forth your word, God, I have direction. If you send forth your word, God, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. You'll make cloudy days with sunny days. Yes, Lord. If I get a word,
yes, Lord. One word,
God.
Yes, Lord.
One word from God can change your whole life.
Yes, Lord.
Word of my God.
Yes, Lord.
He said, write the vision.
Mm-hmm.
Write means to subscribe.
Mm-hmm.
You ever subscribe for educational things? When somebody subscribes, that means that they pay before the material to get there. Each month you subscribe to get in certain educational information. God's going to give you a plan. You have to be able to be the first to subscribe. I told you it means to pay before it get there. It means to sow before it get there. You ain't even seen a magazine in person, but they told you they're going to send it. So what you did is that you sowed until the magazine got there. Say to God, in the kingdom of God, you got to be able to sow in something way before it get there. I'm telling you, you got to know it is sowing your praise. God ain't did it yet, but I'm going to sow in some praise. I'm going to sow in some worship. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. I'm going to magnify God. Before that thing get here, I'm going to subscribe to my own vision.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I'm going to give it to the vision. A personal vision and a corporate vision. We got personal vision that God is telling us between us and him. Then we got a corporate vision, which means our brothers and sisters. Everybody that we come in contact with, this is a corporate vision. This is what God is doing. I'm going to sow it to my own personal vision. I'm going to sow it to the corporate vision. I'm going to write the vision. Whatever God showed me from this point on, I'm going to write the vision. Some of you haven't gotten no vision from God yet, but let me tell you something. God getting ready to give you a vision. God getting ready to give you some goals. And God getting ready to give you some plans, even for your marriage. You asking God, God, what should I do? But God said, I'm going to show you what to do. God said, you might not like it, but I'm going to show you what to do. He said, I'm going to give you a vision for that marriage. He said, I want you to describe it. I want you to prescribe. He said, I want you to subscribe. I want you to sow it to the marriage.
Oh, my God. Yes.
So go over there and cook that wife something.
Yes, Lord.
And bring it to her.
Yes,
so you can subscribe. Because I'm sowing to you,
yes.
Get some back later. Do you hear me? Says God. Because I trust my God. He said, I want you to inscribe. Which means to write in the heart.
Yes.
It means to engrave.
Yes.
Let God engrave his plans on your heart. Get that other stuff off your heart. Stuff that different men and different women wrote on your heart. I'm talking about stuff that your enemies said and your haters said. Something said out their mouth and it's down in your heart. No, baby, before you leave here today, you're going to push all that junk out and say, God, I should have right up in my heart. Tell me what you call me. You have God. You know my right. somebody a vision if you have not explained it to them.
Yes.
You will know what the vision in your life is until, first of all, you let God explain it to you.
Yes.
Stop letting everybody else tell you what your vision and what your purpose is and say, God, you explain it to me.
Yes.
And when you come into the house of God, when God tells you, the pastor come out and say, this says the Lord. You say, oh my God, how do you know that? Some man or woman of God will come to you and say, man or woman of God, thus says the Lord. And you'll know that it's from God because God had already told you and already been working on your heart. You have to ask God, you got to get ready for the vision. Look at your name and say, get ready for the vision. Get ready for the presence of God. Get ready for the function of God. Get ready for the power of the Holy Ghost. Get ready for the strong of the Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Get ready for a word. A word is going to bring deliverance. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Write
the vision.
Write the vision.
And make it plain.
Make it plain.
So that he may run who read it.
Yes, Lord.
You can't run until first of all you read it.
Yes.
Listen, back in this time before somebody, before an army took off running, they had to have directions. We got to have the vision.
Uh-huh.
Before we can take off running. Don't ever run and you don't get no direction from God. Now, Pastor Ellie, for so many years, I was running through life. I didn't have no plans from God. And that's because I kept on running through walls. But now, I got some plans from God.
Yes.
Now, I got some purpose from God. Now, I got a vision from God so that he may run.
Uh-huh.
And when you get the vision, you better run.
Yes,
when God tell you what he called you to do, you better run. Oh, don't you stop, don't you sit there, don't you slow play, don't you listen to what people say. You gonna have some haters, they're gonna try to stop you from running, but you gotta tell yourself, when God give me the vision, when I get through reading, I'm gonna take off running. Yes, sir, yes, sir. I'm running for my family, I'm running for myself, I'm running for other people that God has connected to me. I gotta run with this thing, I gotta run with his word, I gotta run with power on me. Yes, sir, yes, sir. The lifting the burden, the struggle, you can break it, the train, and break it, and feather. So he may run.
Yes.
Who? Read it.
Mm-hmm.
Read the vision God gave you.
Uh-huh.
Take time to say, God, what did you call me to do?
What do you call
me? Look at verse 3. What do it say? Read that, Dad.
For the vision is yet for you an opportunity, appointed time.
Appointed time. He said, for the thing that I told you is for appointed time. Sometimes when God gives you something, it don't happen right then.
Yes.
It's for a point in time.
Yes.
Now, says God, this is when we get discouraged because that thing had came to pass. But what you need to understand, that it's for a point in time.
Yes.
A point in time means a fixed time or a fixed season. You didn't fix it. God fixed it. And it can't show up until that fixed time or that fixed season come to pass.
Yes.
You wait on God for something. It's been a whole year. You've been kicking and screaming. And God, I'm getting tired of waiting on you. And I'm about to give up. But let me tell you something. I'm going to give you a revelation. It's not going to come until that fixed time.
Oh, yes.
Now, in some vegetables, you can go out and sow. And they'll come up within a month. But you got some vegetables you sow. It take a whole year for it to come up. Sometimes you sow something, you get that blessing back right in. And sometimes you sow something where it's money, where it's your time with God, you might not see it till the next year. But it's in God's fixed time. Even time, me and my wife have sold money to other ministries and sold money into this house. And guess what? As soon as we sold it, we got it right back. God did something great. But it's been some stuff we've sold, it's been years, and it ain't came back yet. Give him and says God, because it's a fixed time. It's a fixed time by God. You need to go ahead and relax and say, God, that's in your time. You better stop worrying yourself. That's in God's time. You can't do nothing about the situation. God, that's in your time. He said, a fixed time.
Uh-huh.
It's going to come to pass at a appointed time.
Uh-huh.
You got an appointment at the doctor. They said 11 o'clock. Go in there at 9 o'clock you want to. You're going to be sitting there. Because it's a fixed time. It's a fixed season. God said, I got an appointed time for you. For you to cut that CD, I got a point of time for you.
Mm-hmm.
For you to write that book, I got a point of time for you.
Yes.
God said, for you to meet those people, God said, I got a point of time for you. It was a point of time for Sister Melissa to be connected to us. It was a point of time.
Yes.
You don't even know sometimes you're finna walk into your appointed time. Because you're just going on in God, and you bump into somebody. She bumped into Sister Lily. Guess what? That was their appointed time. But Lily was in her place at the right time, so she can be of some help to Sister Melissa. That was both of their appointed time. You hear me say, God already got it fixed. Look at your name and say, God already got it fixed.
God already
got that marriage fixed. God already got that child fixed. And just say, God, appointed time.
Appointed time. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
fixed time.
Mm-hmm.
It's in God's timing.
Oh, yes.
But at the end, it's going to speak.
It's going to speak.
End means afterwards.
Uh-huh.
Which means after you went through what you went through, then that thing shows up and speaks.
Oh, yes.
He said at the end. Somebody say end.
End.
At the end. See, we don't want to wait till the end. But I told you end means after. I mean, after what? After you waited, after you called on God, after you obeyed God, after you soiled, after you spent time with God, after you've been in fasting, after you went in prayer, then that thing shows up and speaks. After, at the end, after.
After.
It's going to show up.
Yes, Lord.
You started telling God, God, give it to me. God said, but you ain't got past your after.
Oh, God.
God said, you still in front of your after. God said, get past your after. After what? After you've done what I told you to do.
Yeah.
Some people believe in God for something, but you haven't done what God told you to do. Therefore, the thing that you believe in God for ain't going to manifest until after you obey God.
After
at the end, it's going to speak. After.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my God. After you've done what God said.
Yes,
at the end. Which means process.
Mm-hmm.
After you went through the process.
Thank you, Lord.
God said that thing's going to speak.
Yes, Lord.
Me and my wife have went through a lot of process.
Mm-hmm.
For the thing that God told us to manifest.
Oh, yeah.
But we had to go through the process.
Yes.
Some of us don't want to go through the process. Do you hear me? Thank God. But me and my wife went through the process. And it's a lot of things that God has spoken to us. We can't walk in it until we go through the process.
Yeah.
Do you hear me? Say, God, stop crying, get up, go through the process.
Oh, yeah.
Stop kicking and screaming, but even if you do kick and scream, you still got to go through the process. You have not went through the process yet, but he said at the end,
uh-huh.
It's going to speak.
It's going to speak.
Which means to breathe. When you look at the word speak up in Hebrew, it means to breathe. It means to blow. It's when you went through the process that God breathed on you.
Yeah.
You hear me? Says God. Sometimes you are weary what you're going through and you feel like you're about to pass out. But right there at the end, God breathed on you.
Yeah.
And you can strip all over again and restore you all over again.
Yes.
And revive you all over again. He said at the end, it's going to speak.
It's going to speak.
Yes, Lord.
And it ain't going to lie.
It ain't going to lie.
Because God said, if I said it, it's going to come to pass. You better get a promise from God.
Oh, yeah.
I said, you better get in God's face and get a promise from him. I'm not worried about dying. I'm not. You know why? Because God gave me a promise.
Yes.
And I know it was God. It ain't something I think. I know it was God. Do you know what I'm doing right now is what God told me a long time ago. I'm not concerned about nothing happening to me. I'm not concerned about no witch or no warlock trying to do anything. Do you know what that's formed against you should never prosper? And every tongue that rises up against me in judgment, you know what I mean? I shall condemn. I'm the hand out of the tail. Brother, I mean, blessing my going in. Blessing my coming out. Come on, says God. God will give me the authority of trouble, serpents, and scorpions. And over all the power of the enemy, and nothing should be the means harm me. I'm going to wait on God. When you lie on me, betray me, whatever, I'm going to wait on God.
Because
at the end, this thing going to speak.
It's
and people leave you sometime before the end come because they think that you miss God or they think, okay, they going to come to pass. But at the end, after the process, this thing is going to manifest. I want to tell somebody on YouTube, you better get ready because you're getting ready to come out the process. And when you come out the process, your thing going to speak. Your child going to be saved. Your body going to be healed. God going to turn that situation around. The ministry is going to get ready to go after the process. At the end, it's going to speak.
My God.
And not lie.
Not lie.
He said, though it tarry.
Though it tarry.
Though it linger.
Uh-huh.
Tarry means to delay.
Mm-hmm.
It comes from the Hebrew word ma, which means to question or hesitate.
Uh-huh.
Because when that thing we wait on God for it begins to linger, we start questioning God and we start hesitating. Oh, yes, we do. At first, we were sitting on the first row of the periods. Now we back on the last row. Because secretly, we about to sneak outside God's house. But I'm telling you, if somebody in here, you better not go back out into the world. I'm telling you, the devil got something for you. Oh, you better have thoughts on getting ready to go back out in the world instead of calling you. But let me tell you something, you better not do it. Let me tell you something, you're going to get yourself in some trouble. You're going to mess around and perish. You need him and say, God, all while you're waiting on God, sometimes it's normal to hesitate and question God when that thing is lingering.
Yes.
But don't you give up on God.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, Lord, Lord.
You got 1 foot almost out. You just waiting for something to happen so you can get the other foot out.
Help God.
Going back to a world who don't even love you.
Oh my God.
Going back around some people who can't even stand you.
Mm.
going around some people that when you was at your lowest, they weren't even there. But now they speaking well to you and tell you that we here for you. They ain't doing nothing but lying. They ain't nothing but demons speaking out of people and trying to get you outside of God's will. We human saints, God, you better keep on waiting on God. I don't care if you question. I don't care if you hesitate. I don't care if that thing linger. You better keep on waiting on God. You human saints, God, it means to linger. It means to hesitate. The word Hebrew word "why" means why, how, and what.
Why, how,
and what. Why? You don't have to wait this long. How are you going to do it? What is going on right now? Why? Because you in your tearing state. You hear the sense of God. Then why are you waiting on God? You're going to have some questions. White said this morning, don't ever think you can't talk to God. And you got men and women of God telling people, don't you question God. I don't question God a whole lot of time. You hear the sense of God. God, if you're going to kill me, God, what's going on? You hear the sense of God. That's my father. That's my daddy. You hear the sense of God. Respectful attitude, God, why?
Why?
He said, though it tarry,
wait for it.
Wait for it.
Yes.
I told you, wait means to bind together. We're coming to a close. It means to bind together. Jesus, I'm the true vine, you are the branches. You got to be bound together with me. He said, if you remove the branches outside the vine, the branch will die. Saints of God, your spirit needs to be bound together with God's spirit while you're waiting on God. Some people don't scream because they're not bound together with God. They give up on the plans and promises of God. But saints of God, while you're waiting on God, make sure your spirit is bound together with Him. Stay in the place of prayer. We heard the word of God say this morning that you got to know how to embrace God. That when you embrace God, that means that I'm bound together with Him. I'm bound together with His spirit. I'm just like Jacob. I'm not going to let you go. I might feel a little pain, but I'm not going to let you go. I might get a little discouraged, but I'm not going to let you go. My spirit is bound together with your God. Keep me, O God. I can't keep myself. Speak to me, O God. I can't speak to myself. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Renew me, O God. I can't renew myself. I'm staying bound.
Wrestling
with God. And I'm feeling pain. And the angel is dragging Jacob around. Let me go. For the daybreak. Sometimes God will tell you to let him go because he tests you. He sees you actually going to do it. But when he told Jacob, let me go. Jacob said, I'm not going to let you go. He said, not until you bless me. They danced all night until the daytime. Do you hear me? Sometimes, saints of God, you have to dance all night with God. Sometimes when you're in your bed, you got to toss and turn and say, God, I need you. And we've been there with you for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Your morning's getting ready to come. You're going to break out with praise. You're going to break out with worship. You're going to break out with excitement. You're going to break out with a new morning. You're going to break out with the goodness of God, the dynamite of God, the power of God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, your wings. Together with you.
Yes, Lord.
Because I can't do it on my own.
I
don't got the strength to stay with you.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Do I want you? No, not based on myself.
Jesus.
But if you give me the passions and desires, I'll chase you.
Yes.
Do you hear me say, God? God, I can't do this by myself, but give me the passions to pray. Give me the passions to fast. Give me the passion to call out to you. Give me the passion to love on you. Give me the passion to obey you, God. Give me the desires, oh God. Strengthen me, oh God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Pour me into your presence. Draw me into your presence, oh God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Keep me bound together with your spirit. It's time for you to cut some soul ties because your spirit has been bound together with other people's spirit. And it got your spirit jacked up. But now today, before you leave out of here, you say, I cut off every unrighteous relationship that I had in the past. My spirit been bound to too many men and too many women and too many things. But right now today, God, let my spirit be bound together with your God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Draw me closer, God. Strengthen me, oh God. When you wait, your spirit is bound together with God. Don't let your spirit be bound together with somebody else. Keep it bound together with God. Don't let your spirit be bound together with some heart and some wine or some alcohol, some drunk, some drug dealer, some man who lying to you, some whoremonger than you. Let me say, God, somebody who don't care nothing about you. You better keep your spirit bound together with God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. That's where you're going to draw your strength, say to God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. God, download into my spirit what you want inside my spirit, oh God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Keep your spirit bound together.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
It needs to hope. When you wait, you hope in God. You hope, my hope is in God.
Yes.
Hope deferred make the heart sick. Don't lose your hope.
Yes.
But keep waiting on God. Hope means something good is going to come our way. I'm believing something good is going to come our way. Some people can't believe that something good is going to come their way.
Yes.
They've been through a whole lot of trials and tribulations.
Yes.
They've been through a lot of stuff when they was young. And they say, don't ever bad stuff come to me. People will tell you, oh, bad stuff, don't ever bad stuff come to me. I don't got no kind of good. Look, let me tell you something, baby. I don't deal in love. Because when it comes to God, I serve, there is no coincidence.
Yes.
If God bless you, he will bless you. Come on, say to God. Oh, God, I'm going to turn this situation around. My hope is wrapped up in God. Though I don't see it, my hope is wrapped up in God. It may be dark and gloomy, but my hope is wrapped up in God.
Yes.
It may have left me, but my hope is wrapped up in God. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord.
Yes.
Your hope.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Wait on God.
Yes.
Hope in God.
Yes, Lord.
Anticipation. It's what the Hebrew word hope means. I mean, wait means. Anticipation means to have some kind of excitement and joy.
Yes.
Do you hear me? Says God. See, we come into the house of God. We tell us how come they so happy, and how come they laid out on the floor, and how come they dancing, and what they believe God for haven't even come to pass. I got some anticipation.
Yes,
yes Lord, yes, Lord.
Yes.
I got some joy.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you for your joy, God. Thank you,
Lord. Oh, I'm waiting. I got joy. Because some of the things waiting me not doing nothing.
Oh, God.
But while I'm waiting, I got some anticipation.
Yes, Lord.
Being here says to God, while I'm waiting, I want to tell you what to do while you're waiting. So it don't seem like you're waiting. Let me give you a revelation. You said, what can I do so I don't feel like I'm waiting? This is when you go to the doctor, you would pick up a magazine. Do you hear me say, why? You don't want to really feel like you're waiting. But says God, I want to tell you what to do while you're waiting. Pick up your spiritual magazine. Pick up the word of God. And while you're waiting on God, keep on reading his word. While you're waiting on God, stay down in the place of prayer. While you're waiting on God, keep on praying. While you're waiting on God, keep on fasting. While you're waiting on God, keep on studying his word. While you're waiting on God, keep on meditating on his word. While you're waiting on God, stay in consecration. While you're waiting on God, stay in the secret place. While you're waiting on God, keep on loving the brethren. While you're waiting on God, keep on walking in the spirit. While you're waiting on God, keep on putting your heart in the hands. While you're waiting on God, keep on praising God. Keep on magnifying God. Keep on shabbaking God. Keep on saying that Judah. While you're waiting on God.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
While you're waiting.
Why you waiting?
Be doing something while you're waiting.
My God.
Be praising while you're waiting.
Yes, Lord.
Be magnifying while you're waiting.
Yes.
I will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on me. As long as your mind is on what you're waiting for, you ain't going to have no peace. But if you get your mind off what you're waiting on, he'll put your mind on him, he'll give you peace.
Yes.
I'll give you an example when we finish. Me and my wife had prayed for a child, and this was years ago. And we prayed for years and years, didn't unhappen. So, okay, God, we kept on praying and believing God. And after a while, we got our mind off of it.
Mm-hmm.
We said, what is this? We working out, losing a lot of weight, going bike ride, just out enjoying each other company. We weren't thinking nothing about a child.
Mm-hmm.
We had got our mind off what we was waiting on.
Yes.
Some of you got your mind, I'm helping you right now today. You ain't gonna say that, but you got your mind on what you waiting on. I'm waiting for God to save the child. I'm waiting on God to do something in my business. I'm waiting on God to bring me a husband. I'm waiting on God to bring me a wife. I'm waiting on God to save the husband. I'm waiting on God to save her. It's something that you waiting on. But say to God, if you get your mind off of what you're waiting on and put your mind on God, it's not gonna seem like you're waiting. If you wait on God, that thing gonna manifest.
Yes.
Me and my wife got out the mind off of it. We was out exercising. Had our mind on God, we got our mind completely off of it. We was out riding a bike one day, and all of a sudden, we used to ride like 5 miles, it wasn't nothing. That day, we hadn't even went a mile. And tiredness just came over us at the same time. I told my wife, I said, don't you feel that? She said, yeah. She said, I feel like I just got tired all of a sudden. God was stopping us because he knew she was praying. I said, maybe we need to turn around and go back. And she said, my stomach is kind of hurting, kind of. I said, well, let's go to the hospital. Went to the hospital. The doctor said, ma'am, you pregnant. We have been waiting all of years. Do you hear me, says God? But when you wait on God, and you keep your mind on God, and you stay bound together with God, and you stay down in the place of prayer, and stay down in the place of fasting, and stay down in the place of praising God, and magnify God, that thing gonna show up. One of you will be going on praising God and thank you, Jesus. They think you're going to run into that man of God. Do them and says God. Because you got your mind off the man and put your mind on God.
Yes.
Stand on your feet around the building.
Yes, Lord.
Whatever you believe in God for,
yes, Lord,
or whatever God promised you, wait on it.
Wait on
it should surely come to pass.
Wait on it.
Thank you, Jesus.